and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have 4 tool updates and 2 general updates to share today. Let's start with Site Explorer. We've introduced the beta version of our new URL rating. You see it in the scorecard and history chart in overview, as well as in this column in the backlinks report. This new URL is an entirely different metric from the old URL shown in legacy reports. It's calculated with new algorithms, which will evolve and improve over time. Moving on, the Best Buy Links report is now live. This report shows you which pages on your target have the most external and internal backlinks pointing to them. We've also added a bunch of new filters, plus the historical mode feature for external backlinks. One way to use this report is to find out which of your competitors' pages have the most links. Just set their domain as a target and click on the HTTP code filter. Then, set a 200 OK filter to see only live pages. From here, a quick look through the results tells you the type of content that attracts links in your industry. Moving on, our final update in Site Explorer is for the SERP features filter. Before, we used to group videos on the top stories. We've now changed this logic to correctly distinguish between these features. Next up, Keywords Explorer. We've added a new feature in the SERP overview widget that lets you compare two SERPs side by side. You can either compare a keyword by date, or compare SERPs for two completely different keywords. Let's move on to Site Audit. We've refined the Ahrefs Links report in URL details with a few improvements. Firstly, we've added more error badges to the Ahrefs Links report, like this one, that shows when the target's returned Ahrefs Link is not matching itself Ahrefs Link. We've also started grouping Ahrefs Links by URL. So now, multiple Ahrefs Links from or to the same URL are merged into one row. You'll notice that this makes the list more compact. On top of that, we've also changed the design of the Ahrefs Links list to a table format, which makes it easier to scan and spot issues. Next up, Content Explorer. We've introduced the News mode alongside the existing All Pages mode. The main difference between the two modes is that All Pages is based on our database of billions of web pages, while News is based on predetermined news domains. So while All Pages mode can help you find the most shared and linked to content on the web, News mode gives a better representation of the overall trend of a topic. Let's take the keyword fidget spinner for example. In All Pages mode, results are pretty distributed over time. In News mode though, we can see that the trend really took off in 2017, and the buzz has died down since. On to our general updates. First up, we've added an endpoint for the Keywords by Top Position chart to API V3, which is the latest version of our API for enterprise plans. You can read all about the cool new features available in API V3 in our API documentation, which I'll leave a link to in the description below. Finally, a quick keyword database update. Search volumes are now available until July 2022 for most keywords. And that's all for today. See you in the next update and have a great day.